It's a mixed bag, really, this week. John Lundstrom's touch and go. We had a slight issue with Connor last week, so we gave him the rest. Obviously, in the game, he was there if we needed him. Nico Raskin had some issues after the game. Ryan Jack's got a little bit. There's no one else coming back right now, so we'll see how we go after training tomorrow. So it's all a little bit up in the air, I would say, in terms of selection right now. But we go there with a strong squad regardless of who's available.
I know you were talking about forward planning and what you want coming this summer in terms of players. Is there an optimal number you want in terms of how many in the squad you want to work with going forward next season?
I think ideally, as a rule of thumb, you'd want, if you had 10 outfield players, you'd want another 10, so two for each position. You'd want an extra striker and an extra goalie, so three goalies, seniors, maybe one young one, and three number nine. So that gives you a rough guide. We've obviously had one or two players that have had injury problems, so you're carrying a slightly larger number. The summer with the contract situation and just with the window opening, whether you're in contract or out, it gives me a chance to maybe get that to where I want it. I think we've got quite an inflated squad, but obviously not everybody's been fit, and in the last few weeks we've just been running with 18, to give you an example.
Does that give people a chance to still work their way into your thoughts when they get back to bed, or just with other circumstances, or have you already made your mind up about who you want?
The lovely thing with us at the moment is, with a third of the season to go, everything's to play for, so we're in a good place compared to where we were maybe a couple of months ago. Our squad looks stronger, our results are stronger. And as you say, the trophies are there still to be won. So I think people's futures are there to be decided as well.
Michael, you talked about on Rangers TV last night, a billboard with four players that might be an example of like the Rangers team. And you mentioned Tom Lawrence, and he's a player you've not had a chance to work with one-to-one, but clearly someone you're excited about because you mentioned him a few things. What is it about him?
Yeah, I'll elaborate on that comment, because when you have 30 players, they're like your sons, and when you name four, 26 could be upset. But the reality is, I was using an analogy that who are the players in our squad, and I was asked a question about how do I see this team playing. Well, you can only play with the players that you have, and so I think that we've got a certain type of players in our club, means the football that we play will be deemed suitable for them. If we talk about Tom's a player that I've seen coming through at Man United as a young boy. I've obviously seen him go on to be an international and play very well down in the Championship. He came into the club, and I thought in the early part of the season, he looked like a fantastic signing, and he was playing to a really strong level. Unfortunately, he's suffered a long-term injury since then, but when he comes back, he's part of this squad moving forward. I think very similar to Malik Tillman, he can play in the final third or he can play for midfield breaking out. He brings international experience, and as I say, he had a fantastic grounding at Man United as a young player, which I saw firsthand. So I'm excited to work with him when he finally returns to our squad.
And how's he doing at the moment? Is there any news on his situation?
There's no imminent return for him in terms of returning to playing. We'd hopeful that he returned to training in a few weeks. He's had a minor setback. It's a delicate one. We've been away to see specialists, but there's no exact timeline on it. It's a matter of him getting out on the grass and starting his rehab and seeing how he feels. He was a long way along with his rehab when we had a minor setback.
Just on Livingston, what sort of test do they pose away from home?
Extremely difficult one. Obviously, they know the surface and the pitch. I like going there because we take a great number of fans there, and their fans are close to the pitch, and I think they have an impact on the game. We know that Davey Abbey's team fired up. It's a squad, funny enough, just in the leaving of Scotland and coming back, the backbone of this team, the goalkeeper I worked with a lot at Liverpool, Shamal George. Morgan Boys was a young player that plays at centre-half coming through the academy. Stevie Kelly was a boy that I had a lot of affection and a lot of thoughts towards his future when he was here, and I think he's been a good player for Livingston this year. And Joel Noble was my striker at Chelsea many, many years ago, under 9s, 10s, 12s and 13s. So I know Joel and his family very well. So there's some familiar faces there. It's important that we go there and put on a really, really strong away performance. Our last away performance in the league was away to Hearts, and it was our best performance to date. So I'm looking for somewhere around that, certainly out of possession.
If I can go back to
that point. Has that surprised you that there's been so much debate in the last few days over that?
No, because I think if you're in the stadium at the time that it happens live, you're unawares of everything. I think what I have is a very unique position that I was close to the pitch. I could speak to the players and I could confer with our bench that obviously had the camera there as well. And it was the right decision to make. It was right for football. It was right for that game. It was right for Malik as well. I think you can see clearly Kamar and Antonio's reaction when the situation happens. And also when you speak to Malik at the time, he's aware as well. I think we should put that to bed now. It was the right thing. It was the right thing for Scottish football as well in general of that cup competition. Unfortunately, in the hours after the game, Ian McCall lost his job. And obviously, if it had been through that reason, I wouldn't want to be sat here today discussing that. It was a difficult moment, but it was the right decision to make. And I think there's no blame apportioned to anybody in the whole situation. It was a big misunderstanding and we move on. And I think from the fans that I've seen and spoken to, I think once they've seen the whole thing, how we have, everyone understands it was the right thing.
There's been a suggestion that had it been a Celtic game, it would be turning the fans against you. How does the status of the game and the importance of it play in your mind in those matters?
This is a route that in this country we go down all the time. And come on, let's not go down that. It was the right thing in that moment to happen. It was the right and fair thing, and let's not go down that road. I think the decision was made for the right reasons.
How is Malik doing after the initial start, mentally, after going to the region?
Yeah, that was the probably thing that I did miss in the whole thing. I didn't realise that obviously the boy had caught him as badly as what he had, and it obviously led to the whole situation, because that's why he's down and he doesn't see the ball's been played out of the pitch. He's fine. There's obviously a lot of emotion in and around after the game, but I think when you see exactly what happened, when you see the video and you guys have replayed it and seen it, it is how we said it. When, you know, that's what happened.
Something that may have got lost last week, obviously, with all of that was first start and a goal for Nico Raskin. How was he settling in on the training pitch?
Yeah, it was a fantastic assist from Nico. It was his first start for us, but also his first start for a long period of time anyway. And I thought he played particularly well. I thought he showed a lot of aggression in his play in terms of his pressing, and he showed a lot of quality as well. It was a nice first impression for the home fans, and it was nice for him to get an assist. And I was absolutely delighted for Antonio Colak scoring the goal, because he's had a tough time as well. So I said after the game, I thought I made maybe one or two too many changes in that game, and you've only got to listen to me there talking about obviously Nico making his first start and Antonio, his first start for a while as well. So overall, we're pleased to get in the next round. We have a home draw as well in the quarter final, which is important.
How are the team adjusting to the no midweek? Obviously, new players coming in, you might think they might want to play a little bit more, but is that giving you a lot more time on the pitch for them to adjust and embed your thoughts?
There's a huge amount of competition right now, which is why I was a bit surprised by the first half performance last week. Fair play to Partick. I thought they took part in a really, really good cup tie. Had a little bit of everything. Controversy, had interesting goals and missed penalties and everything that you'd want in a cup tie. But I was expecting a stronger performance from us. I think that the boys need to earn their shirt in training as much as they do in match days as well. Well, I think if you looked at probability, the probability is low, because the games are running out, like you said, and there's only so many games left. I think we're in very, very good form. So Celtic are also therefore in very, very good form, and their forms run longer than ours. So you'd say it's outstanding form. What I would say is momentum can change things in football. And so all we have to do is keep doing our job and hope the momentum changes. If it doesn't, we still have to win games for Rangers and build our team stronger for the cup competitions and what's to come. We cannot put a foot off of it. That's why I was a little bit annoyed at the weekend's performance.
Can I ask about just another one briefly? You talked about, again, Ryan Kent and Alfredo Morelos. You talked a lot about it. It feels like there's an inevitable sort of building of, in the words you're using, that you're talking about leaving the front door with a head high.
The talks are ongoing. The club know my feelings on it. The players and their representatives are talking. I think the way that this club ends this season will determine everything for more than just those players. I think that there's a lot to play for at this moment in time. We know the emotions in this city based around where you finish and whether you hold trophy above your head between now and the end of the season. I think that has a big part to play in terms of a makeup of our squad next year. So. There's certainly any comments I've made recently are not to show that I'm less confident. If anything, I'm more confident today. The talks have been ongoing all the time. What I try to do with the players is just give them room to breathe a little bit. We've had to win every game that's in front of us, both in the league and in the cup competitions. We've got a cup final coming up. We've got a big away game this weekend. Now's not the time for me to be giving any ultimatums or for the players to put in any this way. We have to focus on these games in front of us. If we do well, I think it makes everything easier.
Do you think it's more encouraging now than what it has been?
Well, I think they're playing better now. So I think, therefore, everybody's in and the team's winning and the team's doing well. And I think then obviously everything feels nice in the world. We know that certainly a big club that can change in the matter of 90 minutes. So it's important we keep focused on the games. Nico just felt a bit of fatigue after the game. We've not took any risks with him. He's not returned to training just yet. He will return to training tomorrow with John Lundstrom. I'll have to take a view on where they're at. Ryan Jack's had a slight problem after the game as well, which is not ideal, if I'm honest. But listen, since I've come back into the club, I've played games when we had no fit centre-backs or anything else. I'm learning to take a deep breath, and I trust whatever team we play on the weekend to get the result. Yeah, I was actually, because I thought his team played ever so well on the day. They put in a stronger performance than some teams in the SPL have done coming to Ibrox. I did warn the players of that. They had good experience in their ranks in terms of players coming to play at Ibrox and players that have played in our league. So yeah, I was surprised. It was an interesting day Sunday. You know, I've not had many days like that in football. I felt quite flat coming away from the stadium afterwards because there was a lot of things that happened, and obviously hearing about Ian's situation as well. I didn't leave the stadium for a couple of hours, so by the time I'd left, I sort of heard that had happened, and I thought, wow, like how much can happen in one day in football, but it is what it is. But I thought it was an interesting day, and some parts of it were not so nice.
Thanks, Case.
Cheers.